We're now joined by Dr. Shuaibu Hussein, media and communication consultant. Thank you for joining us.
The pleasure is mine.
Globally, there have been apprehension about a second wave of COVID-19. Do you share this concern?
Yes, I do. I really do. As you see, the numbers are increasing by the day. Although the good thing about the numbers increasing is that we are discharging people, but the number of people we're discharging does not equal the number of people that are affected daily. So there is really a new wave, especially with the relaxing of the lockdown that has really made the news to for us to record so many other patients. And if you see what is happening in the north, particularly in Kano now, it's something else we can't understand. Earlier today, we heard what happened in Hadejia, and this is going to continue as long as we don't take proactive measures, as long as we don't try to do what is required of every stakeholder. And that is from us as individuals and then the respective state government, local government authorities, and even the federal government.
Looking at the situation in Nigeria, do you see any loophole or negligence that could trigger the so-called second wave?
Yes, I think we're not doing so much in terms of, enlightenment. I think there's so much ignorance that is going on. So we are talking so much about building isolation centers. We're talking so much about looking for cure and all that. But we're not talking so much about trying to educate people, trying to make people know that, yes, the lockdown may make you to be hungry, but is it not better for you to be alive? Because the man who is dead does not eat, you know. There's so much misinformation and disinformation that is going on. So we're not looking at the area of communication. We're not looking at the area of enlightenment. We're more particular about, oh, wear face mask, oh, use sanitizer. Those are very good. But let people know why they are using face masks and sanitizer. There are a few videos I've seen where some ladies are asked, why are they holding sanitizers? They don't know. Why are they wearing face masks? They don't know. Why are they? Some people even do this as fashion items and the rest. So we really need to enlighten people. Do that in local languages. Go to the rural areas and let them know. Some people in the rural areas don't even know what's going on. They don't even know about lockdown. They don't even know. People who don't even leave their environment don't even know what's going on. So we need to, the gap there is in the gap of communication. There's so much disinformation, especially on social media. And we need to block that area, because once we don't block that area, there's so much in terms of ignorance that will pervade the system. And the more we have people who are not enlightened, the more we have people who don't know about what's going on, the more we have, you know, community spread of the virus.
How can the present gradual easing of the lockdown be managed in a manner to avoid an explosion of community transmission?
I think we should tighten up security at our borders. We should tighten up security at our borders. We should also, I mean, it's okay to ease up the businesses and economies, but no, we don't all have to go to work. We don't all have to go out. I mean, I like the approach of asking the federal government, asking civil servants from level 15 above. I like the approach of asking civil servants in Lagos not to resume and all that. But we should also speak perhaps to the Manufacturers Association and the business owners. We need to call them. Sometimes there are some staff that don't need to be around. They don't have to go to work. So we can begin from that. But above all, we need to tighten the security. I tell you that we have so many influx of people into the state. You see, one way to take care of the spread of a virus is, I mean, look at what is happening in Cross River State. It's a model that I think a lot of people should take from. When he heard about COVID-19, he closed his borders. You don't go out of Cross River and you don't come into Cross River. If you're in Cross River, stay. If you're not in Cross River, you cannot come into Cross River. And then everybody put on face mask and then use the sanitizer. If we were that conscious in Cross River State, if we were that conscious, I'm not sure this thing will have spread. So right now, what we need to do, we need to stop as many people from moving as possible. And we'll make it impossible for them to even move, like what they are doing in Lagos. I mean, in Lagos now, if you enter a Danfo and you are carrying more than 11 passengers, they will ask the extra passengers to come down and trek. By the time you do that twice, nobody will tell you to stay at home. We should strengthen the measures, even though they don't want to stay at home, strengthen everything that will make it impossible for them to go. And we need to talk to our banks. I mean, this is the time where we should be doing mostly e-banking. We don't really have to go. So they need to do more with their ATM machines. They need to do more of online transactions. I mean, if I want to update my ATM card, I don't have to go to the bank. If I want to do any transaction that has to do with e, somebody should be able to be there to talk to me.
Due to time, let me quickly ask you this question. Testing is an issue. Testing continues to raise the dust when it comes to this COVID-19. What would be your advice as to strategy that can be used to quickly improve our testing capacity?
Well, I think that we should decentralize testing. I want to strongly suggest that we decentralize testing. We shouldn't leave it to NCDC alone. We should allow those structures to trickle down up to the local government areas. And we do not allow us to pick up samples from the local government, from the state, and then take them to Abuja before we bring them back. Those time that we spend in analyzing and then releasing the results, you know, creates a lot of confusion. So we need to decentralize testing. We should have testing centers in every state. Somebody should not pick up a sample from Ekiti, for instance, and travel as far as Abuja to go and test the sample. That's why we are having this delay in releasing of results. That's why we have to wait for NCDC till in the night for them to release the results. But if we decentralize, as is happening, we're testing more people, and then we're getting results real time, and then we're updating our records, and then we're knowing those who are discharged and those who are going to patients. So we need to decentralize the testing system.
All right, Doctor. Thank you very much for your input on the news.
My pleasure.